Hi students, today our topic is shading. Shading is one of the very important element to make our art piece more natural. So shading requires some tonal values. What are the tonal values? Suppose here basically we have four tones mainly. Those are darker tone, so very darker tone, say like one angle stroke. I am using slanting strokes, applying more pressure to bring more darkness, more pressure on the pencil to bring more darkness in this area. This is a very dark tone, and dark tone reducing the pressure, just spreading the strokes like in same angle in slant way, like this. And say medium tone, more less pressure than this, than before tone. This is the medium shade. And lightest shade, so lightest tone, very lighter tone, this just touching the paper, that's it, no pressure, nothing, just touch the paper and lightly you do this. This way basically four levels of the tones we require to do any shading. Next, these tones if you do in sequence, in sequence, like your darker, like first tone, whatever the first tone we did, darkest tone, so very darkest, darker tone, and slowly reducing the pressure on the pencil will get darker tone. And first here darkest tone, and next darker tone, darker tone to medium tone, so medium tone, medium tone to light tone, medium tone to, so light tone to slowly coming into white, joining with this white area. White already we have paper, so just this light tone we are joining with this white paper became white tone. So this way tones we have to create together gradually darker to lighter is called gradation. So gradation, these are just tones or shading, anything we can say, tones or shades or shading, anything. Okay. This way we have shading methods. In this, strokes are very important. Like what type of strokes we are using, sometimes we need to use like horizontal strokes, sometimes we need to use vertical strokes. These strokes depends on the dimension of the object. If object is in cylinder, we use curved strokes, or we can use slant strokes. Okay, it depends on the object. Like how we manage the strokes based on the object, like dimension of the object. This way we use different types of strokes. Sometimes we use crisscross strokes, like this way we do slant, and this way, this way crisscross strokes also we use to create more darkness. Again, if you repeat in another angle, again in another angle, if you repeat, keep on doing one layer on another layer, the darkness will get increased. So this way the strokes also very important to do any shading. This level, like darker level to lighter level, we have to balance very carefully. That is very important to do any shading work beautifully. This gradation, if you observe, the order, the sequence is happened gradually. The gradation shouldn't be like this. Gradation shouldn't be like darker tone immediately, lighter tone, shouldn't be like this. Gradation must be like properly and gradually the tone should change like this. This way we have to try to get proper shading. Okay, these all points are very important to do any shading. Now I am going to show you how to shade a cup. Simply I am using one 2B pencil, one 6B pencil. 2B pencil is very sharp, like I sharpened it, the tip is very sharp, you can observe, and this is bit blunt, 6B is a little blunt. Now I am drawing a cup. To draw cup perfectly, first I am taking one straight line, and here using symmetry, this line I am using for to balance the symmetry structure. Like both the sides equally I am doing from this line. After doing it, here I use slightly curves. From here I am making this here slant, and joining these two edges using curve shape like this. So symmetry is very important. You have to balance symmetry, both the sides equally have to balance from here to here how much space, here to here same space, here to here how much space, here to here same space. Balancing space from the line both the sides is very very important. After here one line, here one line, next these two lines joining with and the curve line like this. After here I am going to draw handle. Everyone used to draw handle here, but how we can draw handle over here, we will see that. Here just take a curve, this curve can reach this line like this, and slowly take here curve shape like question mark angle, like how we draw question mark, same way like this almost. After drawing that, draw another line, just take it bit down and draw another line parallelly with that, same parallel to that first line like this. After drawing this, here just take a line and join this, it separates, this is the bend of the handle. This way we did the handle like this. After drawing this handle, now our outline is almost ready. Just leave some thin gap by giving another parallel line to this tip. Even here also leave some gap by giving another parallel line to that curve. After using 2B pencil, the same pencil what I used to sketch, same pencil I am using like this, and making light shade, just applying pencil lightly. And if lines are too longer, you have to move hand like this, like this, like this, like move your hand if lines are too long to get perfect slant lines. If you don't move hand, if you don't do without movement of the hand, if you move only pencil, you don't get the long lines. If you move hand, you will get the long lines easily like this. Keep moving hand. After this, just repeat again down of this second line. Here we left, we gave two lines, right, for the tip. Don't fill any shade in this, just down of this tip. Repeat again, bit darker shade in same angle, but very small lines like this. Here also same shade you continue. Here also in same angle, don't change the angle. Like this continuously. And same shade you do from here and join with this angle. Like this. This way. After here, the same shade you continue till the end of this cup line. Here this handle you leave, and inside just continue same shading and in same angle. And here also you can leave some white portion over here like this. You can mark lightly if you want to leave white portion, you can mark lightly like this, lightly this way you can mark, and shade above on that. This way, just fill the right side portion, because light source we have from here, so that light falling on the cup at this side and the other side we do not have light source, because in shading always we have to take one light source, that is better to shade easily. This side is dark and this side is lighting. This way, after inside also, inside the cup, leave this tip, leave this tip just inside. Also, you shade in the same angle, slant, and here lightly. Here a bit darker. Just 2B pencil I am using now. Later we develop the tones by using 6B also. Okay. Here I am using a scowl line, making little darker, and here also same slant strokes, here also same slant strokes but bit lightly like this. Just shade it in horizontal curve using horizontal curve lines. Just shade this. Like this. After making it, now I am using 6B pencil. Wherever the dark tones I want to do their particular areas, using 6B pencil to increase this darkness a bit. This is dark tone, not very dark tone, just dark tone I am doing. Even here also doing the same dark tone, and this dark tone I am blending with this medium tone. This is the medium tone. I am blending this dark tone with this medium tone. I am making this gradation properly like this, joining lightly with the down shades, and here also more dark. Here very dark I am doing because it is bottom area, lighting can't reach. Like it won't be reached here. So here bottoms always we can do little darker than above portions. above portions are this, so below portions are this, bottoms are this. This can be bit darker than this portion, like this. Here also some strokes I am giving like this. This here I am doing continuity till the end like this. Here also I am giving little more darker shades like this, and inside again this side we have to make darker, because lighting won't reach this side. The outside of the body lighting will reach left. If the inside of the body lighting will reach the opposite angle to the outside body. Okay, that practically if you check by taking a glass or a cup, you will understand how lighting fall inside and outside of the object like this. Here more darker. After this, make this tip neatly by giving one thin straight line like this. After, on the handle, use this 6B, just shade here and leave thin gap and shade like this. And here leave thin gap at the left edge and shade like this, and leave here, and here lightly join these two. After this, this portion you spread the shading bit lightly and leave this portion for lighting, and here you do again some darker color, like darker tone, this one. After this, inside this line leave some thin gap and give this line clearly, and inside again you shade a bit like this. And beside of this shape, just dark here, and beside of this shape, dark here, dark here, like this. And here some darker shadow, like very darker, and spread this darker tone here, this way. And here also close the shape and spread here also like this. And here you can make little more darker to show this handle more clearly separated from the cup like this. After this, to highlight this picture now, this background, lightly if you shade this will highlight, this cup will highlight. Now if you don't shade like this, behind the bright portions or white portions won't highlight properly. So this way shades behind the bright portions or white portions of the object. Shade like this, and here also here we show shadow of the cup. We separate cup and shadow by giving some darker lines like this with the shadow. We can separate this because if lighting comes from here, shadow falls here down here. This way we can show the cup shading. Okay students, you also try this with the help of shading techniques, and tones you need to balance properly. That is very very important to get good effects and after doing this, any one object keep in front of you, observe the lightings and shades and shadows and try that object by keeping in front of you to understand more and better good effects you will get. If you try that way, only thing you have to draw properly, that is important. Okay, all the best, see you later.